band. Landscape on my new phone. Took me ages, but I did find it. So I'm gonna. Yeah, I'm looking at the wrong place. That's where my keyboard is. Good evening. It's 25 of the 7th, 2018. My name is Michelle, and I'm the moderator of Violet. Yeah. Start again. Biodegradable Living. My name is Michelle, and I'm the moderator of Biodegradable Living Movement. This is one of my channels, YouTube. I've been up for about 3 weeks. The reason why I started, and I think I've given you the intro on here in YouTube. Just give you a quick intro just in case you've just joined my channel, but you're just looking at my channel. I come from New Zealand, which is in the Pacific, and we have the South and the North Island. And to my dismay this year, I didn't realize that our recyclables, 85% of it was going overseas. I didn't know that. I thought we recycled everything here in New Zealand. Well, naive am I? How naive am I? At the moment, China has shut their floodgates to everybody in the world, so you know, they can take any of their plastics to China. China has been the big buyer for plastics for probably about 35 years. So they've just shut the gates. So there's a lot of rubbish, a lot of plastic recyclables sitting on all over New Zealand. Some have managed to get new contracts elsewhere, but some are already sitting on, and it's not going to get any better, it's just going to get it worse. And there's some months and months of plastic already sitting in some of the ports. Anyway, it's good. I'm happy about new phone wasn't giving me landscape, it was only giving me portrait, and I was getting quite annoyed. But now it's giving me landscape. Anyway, going back to pollution plastic, it's not good. It's not good in New Zealand, and it's not good in the world. So why I decided to put these channels up, one here on YouTube, one on Facebook, and also one on Instagram. That's out, especially to New Zealanders. How much do we really know about what's going on with plastic pollution? We don't. It's only because imagery that's coming through social media has gone viral in the last maybe year or 18 months. That's really opened my eyes up to it anyway. I honestly thought we're arm's length away from what's going on, but we're not really, because now we've been told that one of our bays, that's Wellington's Oriental Bay, has some of the worst levels of plastic pollution in the world. And I've just found that report, and I'm just going to show you now. I'm going to give you the report here so you can listen to it. And I'm shocked myself. So at the moment, I've been networking and finding and researching all the information for the last 2 years in regards to pollution plastic, where is New Zealand at, where we're going, and what have we done. It's good to see the countdown and all the other big corporates coming behind and ending the single plastic use of single plastic bags and putting alternative ones. Yeah, that is a good sign for New Zealand, considering there's so many tons, millions of tons going into water. We also have New York, so there's people that are going that way, changing slowly. So everybody can do their part, and that's good to see, but I'm just going to give you this report from NewsHub. It was reported on the 27th of the 2nd, 2018, but I just got sent to me last week by another person that knows that I'm following it. So I found the recording, so I'm going to let you have a little listen to it, and yeah. So this is the recording now. I'm just going to turn my camera over. There we go.
Worst levels of plastic pollution in the world. It comes as a more than 65,000 strong end to single-use plastic bags. Alex Baird with the story.
When most think of Oriental Bay, this is the last thing they'd imagine. 200,000 plastic fragments, some of them toxic, mixed in with the golden sand.
I cried. My fingers, when we actually sat there and I looked at my friend who's done this work all around the world, and the blood, who's from Aotearoa as well, and the blood just had drained from her face. We were like, this is the worst we've seen.
Researcher Erickson from the Five Gyres Institute revealed the shocking find.
I can say, having done this around the world, 60,000 miles of sailing in all oceans to study plastics, this is one of the worst beaches I have seen.
He's been on board a double-hulled waka traveling down the North Island coast.
We found more plastics in just some square meters than surveying the entire coast from Napier to here. So we were finding mostly these small pre-production plastic pellets.
Waka Hodua like this one have already done 13 tests across the country, trying to work out just how much plastic is in our seas, and the results aren't pretty.
A device trawling behind the waka is used to collect the waste and data. Today's testing in Wellington Harbour showed where all those pellets in Oriental Bay are coming from.
Once they're small pieces, there's really no system in the world that can clean them up.
The sobering findings have come at a time when political pressure is mounting on the government to come up with a solution.
I think the strength of this petition, the number of New Zealanders who signed it, and just the people who contacted me, it is an issue New Zealanders care about.
Today's Greenpeace petition has garnered high-profile supporters such as Helen Clark and Sam Neill, who hope their voices will add weight to a ban on single-use plastic bags.
Right now,
Alex
speak.
Beard, News Hub.
So, single-use plastics is happening as we speak. They will be banned by the end of 2019. Corporate have come to the party. And the government have also said they're going to compulsory ban them right throughout New Zealand. So that's happening at the moment. But I just wanted to show you Oriental Bay has one of the worst pollution bays in the world. Not in New Zealand, in the world. So what's that telling you, what's happening with New Zealand water? A lot of pollution out there. So I just thought I'd let you see that little clip that I found. I have been promoting it hard out on Facebook, and I just wanted to find the clip and show you. The scientist is a director of an institute that researches pollution plastic around the world. So coming from him, that's a big no-no, knowing that pollution's really bad here. So I'll let you know. Get me on here on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook. Have a good one.